Welcome back to Freak Out Fishing, guys. It is still winter, it is still February, and it is still freezing cold. Today we're going to talk about bait casters, removing line, applying line, and how to cast a bait caster. I have a lot of fishing buddies who exclusively use spinning rod and reel setups, so I always ask them, why don't you try a bait caster? And they always usually say they don't have the patience for it, they don't know how to, because become bait casters, if you ever do it for the first time, it takes a lot of practice, a lot of backlashes, a lot of getting your backlash out and all that kind of good stuff. So today we're going to spool up my Abu Garcia 6-4-1 ratio bait casting reel. It's got six ball bearings, it's a Silver Max, it's an awesome bait casting reel. I've had it for about 4 or 5 years. I've beat this thing up and it never ceases to amaze me. It still works, it's smooth, it's solid, caught a lot of big fish on it. Love this thing to death. So we're gonna spool it up with 10 pound Berkley Vanish fluorocarbon line. I usually go with either 10 pound or 12 pound, nothing more than that though. I usually use my fluorocarbon set up with, you know, swim baits, Texas rig most of the time, perhaps maybe even some jig applications and things of that nature. Also have another bait caster spooled up with 20 pound spider wire line as well. So today we're going to actually give away a spool of 20 pound spider wire line. So stick around to the end of the video and see how you guys can win this spool of spider wire 20 pound braid line. You can pick this stuff up pretty much everywhere: Walmart, Dick's, Sporting Goods, or even Bass Pro Shop, Cabela's, whatever, what have you. It's really good stuff. So without further ado, let's get in the garage, freeze our hands off, and see if we can't spool this stuff up. Here we go. First step, we're gonna take this line off. Look it, and just take it off. Do it by hand. Do it any pretty much way you want, but just make sure that you throw away properly this line. We don't want to leave line laying around for wildlife purposes, children purposes, our pets, and all that kind of stuff. So let's take this off real quick and dispose of it correctly. Now what I'm taking off of here is 10 pound fluorocarbon line, but if you can see, the memory of this line is starting to really get on that reel, that spool. And once that starts happening, guys, you probably want to start thinking about changing your line. This line's been on here for a long time, probably about, I don't know, probably close to a year. And I usually leave my line on there for pretty much almost a year, unless I need to really get it off of there. If it be a real nasty bird's nest or something like that, and yes, Roy does bird nest his spool on his bait casting reel. But let's take this off real quick and we will be right back. All right, the line is completely off. Now, if you can see, there are holes in the spool right here. Many, many holes all throughout and around the entire spool. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take our fresh line and we're gonna go through two of them. We're gonna go through in one and out the other and just tie a simple clinch knot. But before we do that, we gotta take our line and put it down every eye leading up down to the actual bait caster herself. So let's do that real quick. Have to keep in mind is never forget to put your line through the actual guide that goes down to the spool. So let's do that first. To the guide. And I'm gonna make a little bit of a slack here. And then we're gonna put this line through one hole. And it takes a little bit of patience, guys, so you have to be a little patient. It's a little tough. Not that hard though. Alright, so I'm in one hole and I'm out the other. And then I'm gonna connect that. And all we need to do next is make an under and over simple knot twice, just to get it connected to the line so it doesn't come off. Under, then over. Hands are freezing because it's like 20 degrees in here. And one, and then another simple over. All the way down. All right, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut off this extra excess. Yep. All right, let's start spooling it up. Now, to get this line on the reel, you got to hold that spool that you bought some way, somehow, so it doesn't come over on itself or anything like that. Now, there's a lot of different ways you can do this. I've done it on an antenna for a car, put my spool onto it, broke through the paper, and then just sat it there and then carefully just spooled it onto the spool. You can get someone with a pencil, break through that paper and have them hold it with two hands. I've simply just put a pencil and a vise, broke that paper for the spool. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So I got my pencil in the clamp. I just put that spool down like so, and it holds it there so that it doesn't move around, fall on the ground or anything like that. So let's get this thing spooled up.
So I don't know if you guys can see it, but it's right there, the spool, the pencil, and the line. I'm gonna just hold the line with my fingertips like this, like here, and then we are going to start spooling it up.
All right, guys, it is fully spooled up. I don't know if you guys can see this or not, because my camera is not the most awesome camera in the world, but there's still some silver left over. I didn't spool it up completely to the brim. I want to leave some space in there, because every time you put brand new fluorocarbon on, you got a good chance of backlashing. So let's head outside. I tied on just a regular big bobber just for some training purposes, and then we're going to go talk about how to cast this bait caster. So let's head outside and let's take a look at that.
So I got the GoPro on. I want to show you guys a little bit of the ins and out of the bait caster itself. You got your drags right here. The drag, the set in or loose or tight as you want. You got your tension knob, which we'll talk about in a second. You got the brake system right here. Now this is like zero to max. That's what this model says. And sometimes it's like 1 to 10 or whatever. Now if you're just now starting out fishing a bait casting reel, I would recommend putting that all the way to either the max or number 10. That's going to reduce your amount of backlash and castability purposes. I would always go to your max or your number 10, depending on what lure you have on. Like right now, like I said, I only got this bobber on. We're going to test out the tension knob. Now, the tension knob is meant for however heavy your lure is. When you cast it, it's going to depend on how much of this line is going to come out at a time due to the heaviness of your lure. I'm going to release the spool, and I'm going to see how fast that lure, or in this case, that bobber, I hope you guys can see that, is going to drop. So let's see how fast it drops, and it's not dropping at all. So this tension knob is going to have to be loosened up a little bit. I'm going to turn it towards me. See how that drops right there? It's dropping ever so lightly. Let's see how fast it drops now. That's about how you want it to be. I'm going to tighten it up just a little bit, and it even goes slower. So that's kind of where I want it. So let's test it out and see how far it goes. Kind of went the wrong way, but no bird's nest, because the tension knob is calibrated correctly and the brake system is all the way to the max. Do a little further. All right, looking pretty good, guys. Let's see how far we can fling this thing without birds nesting up here. No bird's nest. Look at that. Perfect cast. I could sit out here all day and do this. Smooth, and it is just a delight. No backlash again. When I first started casting or using a bait casting rod and reel setup, that's all I did. I sat out in my backyard and I just made cast after cast after cast. And I'll tell you what, guys, it took me a good long while to figure this out. But once you do, so many techniques, so many setups, so many situations you can fish with. And I love it. I haven't really gone back yet. I don't use a whole lot of spinning rod setups, only in certain situations, maybe like a drop shot or some kind of finesse application. But the spinning, not spinning, but the bait casting rod reel setup is one of my favorite ways to go fishing.
So there you go, guys. Hope that video wasn't too boring for you. Hope you guys learned something about bait casting reels. Never fished one before, make sure you go out there and pick one up, or find a buddy or something to see if you can't practice. It takes a lot of practice, it takes a lot of patience, but if you guys stick with it and crack that code, it opens up a whole new world of bass fishing up for you. If you guys want this spider wire 20 pound braid. We are giving this stuff away today. So to get it, you gotta be a subscriber, you gotta like this video, and you gotta go all the way down to the bottom and comment on what you would like to see next on the technical gear side of fishing. And we'll pick a random subscriber in the next couple weeks. Please like, subscribe, comment. We'll see you guys on the next one. We're out of here.